People assume that all extreme couponers are hoarders and purchase items unnecessarily because they're free or because they're going to make money on them. If I can use the overage on that item to purchase items that my family does need, then I do need that item. We purchase extra, we're going to donate them, or we're going to give them to families that can use them. Things are not going to go to waste.
Despite the perceived stigma, today Kelly is prepared to finally reveal her couponing secret to a close friend.
My friend Candy and I have been best friends since high school, and we talk about everything but couponing. So I'm really anxious to see her reaction. So we've known each other a long time, but there's one thing you don't know about me. I am a closeted extreme couponer, and this is my stockpile.
Wow. Kelly! I'm speechless.
Kelly's stockpile includes close to 50 containers of laundry detergent, over 60 different cleaning supplies, and 36 bottles of hair care products.
I had no idea. Why did you wait so long to show me all this?
I'm sorry.
I'm jealous, and I'm a little hurt. That just means she'll have to reveal a lot more of her secrets to make up for it.
Where do you find the coupons, and how do you start the whole process?
Well, I'm going to show you a little bit of what I do.
With 11-year-old daughter Natalie's help, Kelly is planning her largest shopping trip ever to give Candy a closer look at her couponing world.
Typically, the sale ad does not include everything that's on sale in the store. So one day after work, I'll do a quick walkthrough of the store, making a quick note of everything that's on sale. Throughout the course of the rest of the week, I'm able to match up the sale items with my coupons.
So where do you get all these?
I have some friends who will give me additional copies of their inserts, and then certain recycle centers will give you their inserts.
Wow, I would have never thought of that.
Kelly has carefully planned out today's shopping trip in the hopes of purchasing close to $1,300 worth of household and grocery items without spending anything out of pocket.
My grocery list is always in spreadsheet form. I always have it with me so I can adjust it on the fly as I'm going through the store. I'm really anxious. Hopefully, the store will have everything in stock and the coupons will pull off without a hitch to make sure that this all goes the way it's planned.
With a detailed digital shopping list and coupon binder in hand, Kelly is ready to take on the store.
Here we go. The noodles are great for lunch. The store is running a 10 for 10 sale, which makes them a dollar. And I have a 50 cent coupon. Our store doubles anything up to 50 cents. So the coupon doubles to a dollar, making the noodles free.
I can't wait to do this myself.
Great deal on vitamins. This week, they're buy one, get one free.
With the store's buy one, get one free special, two bottles of vitamins cost $4.25 or $2.12 for one. Kelly has coupons for $2 off each, which means she will only spend a little over 12 cents per bottle.
With a buy one, get one free sale, I can usually use two coupons because you're still getting two items. So for 15 bottles, it's only going to cost
$1.88. Wow.
Oh, I see closeout stickers. Jackpot. This one's gonna be a moneymaker. I can't pass this one up. This item is on closeout for 81 cents. I have some 50 cent coupons, which will double to a dollar, so I'm gonna make 19 cents a piece.
When a coupon value is worth more than the price of the product, some stores like Kelly's will allow customers to use the difference or overage toward their overall purchase.
I'm always on the lookout for an overage because that's the key to paying for the other items that I'm never gonna have a coupon for. That's how you get the zero balance. To the register we go.
With multiple carts full of food, cleaning products, and household necessities, Kelly, Candy, and Natalie are ready to check out.
The slightest mistake can throw off the total. I'm gonna try to do everything I can to make sure that everything goes smoothly, but we'll see. Yeah, if we can just kind of methodically, like, let me get, like, all the tissue up and kind of just, I just feel better. Feeling anxious, making sure everything is in order. At the moment, I'm at over $600. If something gets messed up now, I may cry.
It'll be stocked up for a while at least.
We are getting close to $1,000.
Your grand total right now is $1,300.03.
Okay, I guess we better get out the coupons, huh? Because I don't have $1,300.
With her total haul rung up, the stress of making sure her detailed plans are correct start to weigh on Kelly's nerves.
I'm shaking. I'm so nervous. I'm down to, well, $828 and change, 27, 26, 25, we're countdown.
I'm like getting nervous.
Under 100, we're on the home stretch. You know what, Candy, there's a couple of items. Is it too late for us to add a couple of items to our transaction?
Realizing she'll have more of an overage than she thought, Kelly re-strategizes her haul on the fly and sends Candy for some last-minute purchases.
Some of the markdown items put us a little bit under where I thought we were going to be. So I'm going to use those extra couple of dollars to get some toilet paper.
Where would it be?
Gotta be on clearance or she's going to be upset with me.
When Candy fails to find the right product, Kelly is forced to take matters into her own hands.
Are you sold out of the toilet paper?
Candy is looking for it.
Do you mean to ask somebody?
Would you mind?
Mr. Padgett, come to register 11, please.
Are you sold out of the toilet paper that's part of your four-day sale? Do you happen to know?
Yeah, we should be able to blame you, right?
Okay.
Could
I get 7 packs of that?
Okay.
Yeah. Thank you.
You're right back.
Thank you very much.
All right. Thank you.
After spending an hour and a half at the register, Kelly adds her last-minute items to the checkout with the hopes of using her overages to cover the cost of the additional products without having to pay anything out of pocket.
And your grand total is a negative 31 cent balance, which means we owe you 31 cents.
This is a perfect way to come out of the coupon closet.
I'm not letting her go back. I'm telling everybody what she's doing. This is amazing.